Hey guys, you Bird Creepers, and welcome back to my FIFA 17 Westerlo career mode, where last time locked off, I once again played and picked up two victories in the league. And you know, the form is just very good at the moment. The team is playing very good. Everything is going well. And I mean, this is exactly what I want. Out of every team, I do a career mode. Excuse me. Sorry about that. So. I have this, like, bad cough that
from the commentary position.
Just can't shake.
Atmosphere.
And the game here today is Lockeren. I'm getting some cough medicine for it there in a minute, so it shouldn't be too bad for much longer with any luck. But overall, I think
the kind of players that we expect, the kind of performances we expect from the individual.
The team is playing well, everything is going well.
The referee, well, he saw it clearly, and he obviously didn't like what he saw.
I just have no reason to complain about this career mode.
He might, I don't know, live to regret it. The player might certainly live to regret it.
We might.
So,
it'll be interesting to see if that affects his game, because he's on a tightrope now.
On the attack here. This with a chance to go into the lead now. He is a saviour there. He's got his tackle in.
I don't know what it is, but I'm not seeming to lose the anger about certain things. In this career mode. I don't know what it is. It's so far in this career mode, I just haven't really put too much thought into decisions that don't get given against, given for, that don't get given for me, I should say. Say like the, like my player tripping over for the defender, or going down like he was, that he got hacked when he was injured. Alright, I'd be like, oh, that's a penalty.
Not really in trouble.
For some reason, this Kerma, I just don't have the urge. I don't feel like I should say that. I don't know what it is.
He's had to go full stretch.
I mean, building a league is no different than any other league, but for some reason, I just, this is like I'm leisure. Yeah. This is more how I react when I'm playing Kermel mode off camera, because you guys know I do the odd Kermel mode off camera, where I'll try different things. Things where Kermel mode off camera, I might use players I've used before. Or FIFA has passed, maybe just to see how will they play. But they wouldn't be players I'd use in these career modes. What's that? And some players I've used in past career modes in this game. It just gives. Gives me a freedom, something to do when I'm not recording. Because, I mean,
they wouldn't be expecting to win.
Like, you guys, my main career mode is Liverpool. I have another Liverpool career mode that you guys have never seen. You know.
Presented possession to the opposition.
Yeah, if you looked at the, you'd be like, who are all these people?
Well,
where is this Chris, do insert name. Whoever.
We'll see.
And that career mode is just, it's just for fun. Just something to do when I'm not recording. Out the weekends. Ends when I have college during the week. Now I don't have that kind of leisure. Or my schedule is more compact. I have to fit 7 videos into a weekend. And as you guys know, with the 3 Liverpool videos normally recorded on a Friday.
Got the tackle in.
And the 4 secondary promo video was recorded on a Saturday. Which is the
got to be. That's a spectacular save.
New. With the new schedule, that's how it works. Now, if I have extra time, I can utilize that to the best of my. Plus, I get more time to myself. I mean, don't get me wrong, I still get time to myself at the week. On Fridays and Saturdays. Especially when I'm waiting for the videos to upload. But I'm not just going to sit there doing nothing. Everyone does it. Every YouTuber. I guarantee you, all your favorite YouTubers, no matter what they do, whenever they're waiting for one of their videos to upload, they either play a game or might spend time with friends and family. I don't know. I don't know playing YouTuber purpose. But
the game gets underway.
I guarantee you that if you know any YouTuber who answers questions, ask them what do they do when they're waiting for a video to. Well, I guarantee you they'll have a pass and they say, yeah, I'll do that when I'm waiting for an upload to finish rendering and posting and all that stuff.
And in comes the header.
That's another thing. If you are getting into YouTube, I would recommend you plan to start YouTube. Make sure you have something that you will enjoy doing off from camera. Now, there are certain things you can do. And certain things you can't do. Now, obviously, this is why I have off-screen career. It's because
for the losing side to fight back.
When I have some past time, when I have some free time, if I want to play FIFA, I don't want to play or my regular career mode that I do for you guys on YouTube. Because if I do that, I've already videos recorded. And while, yes, I could technically record more videos. That would just eat more of my time.
Strike, that connection wasn't quite as clean as
I can do it leisurely.
I did think that this would be one of the tightest games we've seen, Alan, but
it's a different kettle of fish.
Because the one side has been knocking the ball about.
And it's something different. Now, if you guys were to see my list of honors, because for the past few FIFAs, I've decided I'll keep track of everything I've accomplished each career mode, you would see that my honors would still read this. And they would match up with what I've done in each career. Because, as I am still winning stuff in the off-screen career mode, I don't count them. I'm not going to put them on the thing, because one day, hey, when I stop doing YouTube, I want to post some for the world to see. Yeah, I want to say these are my honors from time. And spend the best I think that in career mode.
It was good progress with this attack.
At the top, how many seasons have passed? How many seasons did I play? And why I do this is because so people can think, okay, he has such amount of this trophy and that trophy, so they can figure out, oh, how I did in each trophy. Like, say if I played 6 seasons and had 6, say if it was an off-screen in Liverpool crew, like which I do, multiple of, on each FIFA. If say I did 6 seasons for YouTube, oh no, I'll get 6 because I've only started 3, season 3, so maybe I'll get 6. I don't.
Good reading of the by anticipating.
It's not like before when I could easily smash through all 15.
He went in well. Could be dangerous. It's a quick break. The shot's on. Terrific stop. He's kept it out. Well, the corner count rises and rises.
Regardless.
Now the
if I have 6 Premier Leagues and say 6 seasons completed, people will say, okay, he won the Premier League every single season.
And he headed it goalwards. Very good stop here.
Ditto for each and every competition. In League Cups, FA Cups, Champions League, Europa League, if I was in the Europa League at all. Well, because sometimes Liverpool are.
Well, they're in a good position here. The break is definitely on. He's got his shot off now. They've scored.
It's easy to read. They are all easy to read. They're easy to understand. And they're easy to look at and say, hey, okay, he is very good. He is what he his accomplishments. He has a right to. Right, because his accomplishments speak for them. I mean,
so they're looking for more at 4-0.
And if I include, say, if I knew with however many the off screen for the ones I did.
3 minutes, that's what's going to be played for added time.
He included them. Hey, someone who watched the seasons on YouTube looked in and said, hang on a second. He's putting up on way more stuff than he actually won. Where did all this come from? Say if it was one of you people watching this video. You'd be very confused. Because you'd see a lot of stuff you didn't see me win. That's one of the reasons I have off screen promos that you guys just never see, because I have no reason to. Like, anyone who has seen me be saving the day in my local promo will notice that there was another crew. Remote save under it. That's a crew remote. What I was doing in my spirit. game. They're on this account and another account. Pretty much all over the place. It's just the way it works. And I think I think it works great. I think it's definitely the way it should be. You shouldn't. Just because you do YouTube videos, the videos should be everything you're about. You should have some way of having fun. And I mean, I can't put it any more simpler than that, ladies and gentlemen. I really can't. So, yeah. As we enter into October, sorry, whoever you are. it's not going to happen. Let's get into the second game of this episode against this team whose name I can't properly pronounce. I mean, Lustron would be my best attempt, but that's probably wrong.
The biggest welcome from me is to Alan Smith.
If you happen to be watching this and you're a fan of this team, I apologize. I don't mean to butcher your team's name. I'm a very ignorant idiot sometimes when it comes to, especially when it comes to pronouncing it. I'm probably not going to be as good at that as I am at winning trophy
and
stuff like that.
The supporters are going crazy. It's a terrific moment for the team. Goalkeeper almost got there, but it wasn't a strong enough touch.
Yeah, but hey, no one's perfect.
Feels he should have done better.
And for all that, 8 goals in the season, his return. That is what you want from your top striker. Are you not?
And working on his birthday, playing for his team. Referees officiating properly here within the laws of the game, quite entitled to give that as a free kick. Although early, sometimes the players expect to get away with it, I think.
Well, it looked like one of those shots that should have been saved.
Yeah, it did take a deflection off the keeper, but the goal was given as is, so. What the? Oh my god, my goalkeeper just got lucky. If that had resulted in me conceding a goal, he would lose his place as quick as that. I would have subbed him there and then. What is this? He is lucky. Wait. He that my defender was in the right place. He's a save his dumbass. I mean, never mind that he fucking palmed it. Instead of leaving it go out, well, I don't care if it was going out for a corner or a goal kick. It does not matter. Leave it go out. If it's a goal kick, you clear it down the pitch. If it's a corner, then you clear the corner. Or one of the defenders will header it out, or you will come out and punch it away. You will palm it. Practically, it was going straight for the opposition. How stupid can you be? This guy is clearly on whatever Simon Mignolet was on during the whole game. Acting like a complete fucking imbecile. Like he's never hit a goal in his life. We have not conceded a goal yet. But if that had been the first one, I don't care if it, what minute it is, I would have subbed that dumbass off immediately. Ignore that. But yeah, I would have subbed him off. That is completely stupid and very risky. He is unbelievably lucky that that did not cost us a goal. I mean, I'm pissed that he almost cost me a goal. Well, you can imagine how pissed I would be if he actually did cost me a goal like that. I might sum him off again. Sum him off if he does it again. I'll have to keep an eye on him. In the future.
That's quite a comfortable save, really. We could be in. It's a big call as we look back on it, because there would have been a real chance to get a goal had the flag stayed down.
Yeah, I think that's why maybe he went just a little bit too early. He knew he was through, the lad, but rightly flagged.
Neither side able to dwell on the ball for very long here. Tackle in. It's looking good, this move. This is how they love to play on the break. Shot up. It's in. Fine moment for them.
Ah, that second goal is going to be a bit of a relief. And after that near her fucking disaster for a few minutes ago.
Confidence to grab the second chance here. Well, it's a goal worth replaying over and over again, isn't it? Restarting at 2-0. Now it goes into the wider areas where they've got a winger waiting. Trying to switch on the attacking power in this situation. Defender to it first. Free kick given.
Oh, don't jump for it, Ginola. Just let it go.
Well, what a good game he's having to this point, Alan.
Well, he's been magnificent so far. And the keeper, quite rightly, has demanded why he hasn't been closing down. Already, he's got himself some goals.
That's not bad. That wouldn't help us a third goal. How would that help?
That's something to aim for. What a marvellous touch.
I can't see any logical reason why a third goal would help us achieve victory in this match. plans. Again, I can't properly read that guy's name when it comes up above his head for whatever reason, position of the ball. So, I mean,
they are playing well. They're superior.
And that's just me. Maybe you guys can read it. I don't know. It kind of looks like it says Christensen. It's similar to a guy, the center back for Borussia Mönchengladbach, who's on loan from Chelsea. His name is Christensen as well.
Well, this attack,
I don't know if it's pronounced like that or what.
He's got his shot off now.
Ooh, that was too close for comfort.
3-0, the halftime score.
That was way too close for comfort.
Alan, sum it up for us. Well, we wonder if the second half's going to be like the first, one-sided. Hassan. Well, they're building steadily here. Working.
Henry.
Should be. Never panicked.
Alpo sticks it in the bottom corner and makes it 4. Yeah. Beautiful.
He's an impetuous goalkeeper, this one, and it's cost him here. Well, he did go AWOL, but the scorer was Johnny on the...
That's what you call the eye of a goal scorer.
It's turning out to be a comfortable game, this. 4-0. Just lent the ball to its mate and got it back again. Came in with the challenge and the ball broke free. Well, the home team has been outplayed and the home supporters have lost their will to support, I think.
Well, haven't they just? You could hear a pin drop here. Seen one or two heading for the exit.
Go on, Bayens. And I realize that's probably not how you pronounce his name, but that's what it looks like. I mean, B-E-Y is by, well, 100% hint. I mean, I don't know how it's pronounced in Belgium, but P-U-Y, for me, spells by. E-N, so... E-N-S. Ins. Ins. Ins.
Looking good, this move. It's good play until they got that challenge in. Did well, stuck out of
the... My apologies if you're, confused or annoyed that I am trying to emphasize is why I'm saying that guy's name to the point of even breaking it down. And I just want people to know. I'm trying my best with the things I can. And get. Like, it's like for this guy, it's giving me I'll pop.
Safety first there. Throw in here. And he's in there with a header. Offside. The officials clearly in agreement.
I think Ginola was offside. Yeah. Sorry, Ginola. Just forgot the B. Yeah, Strömberg. For some reason, it's giving me a completely different name whenever he's on the ball. Well, but
literally to the opposition.
Alpo, it's short, it's simple, it's easy to remember.
He's coming forward with some danger.
Must be some reason that the game is giving me that as an option for his name, so I'll use it.
Gonna be a substitute.
It's a handy little nickname. If anything else, because it's not his first name for sure, because his first name starts with a C.
Very good could be dangerous. This could be it.
Gamboa! Wow. I don't quite know what to say to that. I really don't.
Referee's had a good look and decided what he's seen from this period of play to add on 3 minutes.
Well, he makes that transition happen quickly.
I didn't know that this match, I was just about to say, will be over any moment, but as if the game was reading my thought, that's just like, oh yeah, it's 90 minutes. Another solid hit victory. And that's another win. I think that's, yep, 10 wins. I'm actually a third of the way feature of the season already, because with 15 teams that would be 30 games. It's, I don't know what this is. Does anyone know what this is? Is there playoffs in the Belgian League? I haven't done a career mode in the Belgian League for ages, so I don't know. Does it go to a playoffs? I don't know. Oh. I mean, I would prefer if it didn't. That'd be great if it didn't, because I don't see why it should. I mean, what was the point? I mean, if you're gonna, what's the point of coming first if it doesn't mean you actually win the league? If anyone knows how this works, because for the life of me, it's been, I'd say, 5 years since I did a career mode in the Pro League. If you guys know, let me go on Twitter. The link is in the description down below. What's at CorePierce4, or in case you don't want me to scroll down. Hit me. Yep, and let me know. If you would please. And it will also look it up if I think about it. Yeah. Can do that before the next episode, actually. Anyway, thanks for watching for this episode. Until the next episode. I hope you enjoyed the video. Till next time, I love you all. Have a very, very nice day. Peace.